Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I know we've all had a really heavy lunch, and this is like the worst time to be on stage. But the energy and the vibe in this room is so palpable, I felt like I was in a party or something. So while I was introspecting about this subject, unheard, I jotted a few of my thoughts on paper, which I'd like to read with you. Here it goes. There was a time not too long ago that following your dreams was a largely hypothetical pursuit. Something you did. Something you did between college and coaching classes for the sake of entrance exams, right? But now, we are in the midst of a fascinating transition, which is evident at and facilitated by platforms like this. The incredible speakers that preceded me, as well as those yet to address us, are great examples of people who follow through on their passions, working on making their dreams a reality, as I'm sure many of you in the audience are doing as well. I know that, I have full faith. I've been fortunate to have had the opportunity to follow through on a childhood dream, to pursue a passion for acting. For the past 10 years, I've had the privilege to be a part of 50 movies in 3 languages, reaching out to millions of people all across. Yes, 50. I'm incredibly proud of that, but considering a movie takes about 6 to 8 months to be made on average, let's just say I'm glad I love what I do. There's been an interesting trend that seems to apply to people who've pursued endeavors that they're passionate about, which I'm sure you've observed as well. For entrepreneurs, startups, actors, and artists who've been chasing their dreams on the silver screen, the journey at a fundamental level is incredibly similar. While the positives of these journeys are routinely felicitated, and rightfully so, by the media, there are certain aspects that are relatively unheard of or not given the attention that they are due. Movies, acting, and pretty much every performing art provide a unique perspective on these less frequently addressed aspects. For a movie or any other performance, the product life cycle, so to speak, is relatively short, with consumers, in this case being fans, providing almost instant feedback. Pivoting when things aren't working out is not really an option. And any changes based on feedback will be viewed in a completely new context, the next movie, with a whole new set of variables. Having been through this cycle 50 times in the past decade, there are a few interesting learnings that I would like to share with you. But before we get into the more significant learnings, here's an easy one. Don't take comments on social media personally. So here it goes. Uncertainty is inevitable, and perseverance in the face of it is pretty much all you can do. There were apprehensions from people close to me about going down this road, given the fairly low probability of even marginal success. My family was concerned when I quit my job and plans to do an MBA to act in movies. And I almost felt vindicated when I landed a lead role in my first film, Lakshmi Kalyanam, which opened to average reviews. Immediately after that, I was essentially jobless for 8 months. There was no work coming my way. I began questioning the decision to go down this road, which was further amplified by those who cared about me. At this point, there were 2 choices: to accept that this wasn't going to work out and go back to the conventional MBA plus corporate job plan, or to continue to pursue my passion and work on developing a skill set that enabled me to do better. Knowing if a decision was the right one is only possible in hindsight. But following your dreams and believing in yourself is truly entirely in your hands. Which brings me to my second point. There will be times when your best efforts may sometimes not be enough. Some time ago, I was offered what I believed was the role of a lifetime. Everything about the role was amazing. It was well written. It would enable me to push my boundaries as an actor. I was incredibly excited about it. And I can safely say that that was the most effort I had ever put into researching and working on a role. Far more than I ever did for my acclaimed films. A lot of my personal and professional commitments were put on hold because I knew that this is what I wanted to do. Fast forward to when the movie released, I was given the reviews which said that my character was annoying but pretty. There will be times when your success or failure will not be entirely your fault. But there will also be times when everything goes wrong purely because of you. If it's the former, there's little you can do about it. But if it's the latter, it is extremely important to be honest with yourself and accept it. This is the only way through which we can grow, learn, and ensure that this never happens again. My third point, you will feel alone and question why you're doing it. Very few of the people around you that matter will be able to relate to what you're doing. There will be times when you have no one to talk to. Not because they aren't there for you, but because they just don't share your perspective. My parents have always been my sounding board throughout my career and have literally been by my side every step of the way. However, there have been times when they have completely disagreed with the decisions that I made, which is completely understandable. For them, their primary goal has always been my well-being. But for me, I was chasing my dreams. There was a time where I was working on two movies simultaneously, Magadheera and Arya 2, both in Telugu. I would shoot for one by the day. Thank you. I'm assuming you guys have seen both. For those who haven't, please go watch it. YouTube it tonight. Okay, so I was working for one during the day and I would move to the second unit by the evening. Averaging about 2 to 3 hours of sleep per night, I would try to squeeze in as many naps as I could between commutes. Yes, it was extremely hard, but this is what I wanted to do. There have also been, of course, vanity vans at that point of time were just not an option. Those days were way too early in my career. And there have been other instances where I've simultaneously shot for two movies in different cities. I would pack up, rush to the airport, go to the next unit, and do it again. It was a drill which went on for a month. But well, I wanted to do all these projects, and the work was very exciting for me. For the longest time, there was no one I could speak to who could relate to what I was dealing with on a daily basis. And it's during these times that you feel all alone. Every pursuit of a passion will have such moments, and it's important to know, even though people may not fully relate, it's amazing how far the people that really care about you go to accommodate your journey. This brings me to the most important learning of my life. Make time for relationships, especially the ones that you take for granted. Absolutely nothing that I have achieved would have been possible without the incredible support of my family and friends. Having said that, it took me a very long time to realize that the people that mattered the most were being taken for granted by me. There's a fine line between relentlessly pursuing your passion and believing that what you're doing is more important than the lives of those around you. I have been guilty of crossing this line more than once. And if there's one thing that I wish I knew at the outset, it would be this. The priorities of those around us, even those without whom our journey would not be possible, tend to take a backseat as we get more involved in our pursuit. It's important to remember that everyone is pursuing something that matters to them, and that we need to be there for them when they need us as well. Making time for the people that matter is something I would urge everyone to do, irrespective of how busy their pursuit is. And my last point, insecurities are normal. Comparisons don't really help. Being an actor immediately puts your life under public scrutiny. What you wear, how you look, your ability to act, your opinions on things that have no relevance to who you are or what you do. Everything, pretty much every aspect of your personal and professional life are up for discussion in the public domain. This, in my opinion, is magnified further for female actors, when no topic, however personal, is off the radar. After a point, this ends up getting to you. Maybe I shouldn't have done that movie. Maybe I really can't dance. After the annoying but pretty review, I actually believed maybe I really can't act. I have been criticized and written off, and have at some point believed in all these things. I learned, perhaps later than I should have, that trying to live up to external benchmarks is a futile exercise. If you feel you need to improve on things, improve on them for your own growth. Not because someone with no perspective on your life said that you should. The only person you should be comparing yourself to is who you were yesterday. Movies can often seem idealistic and a little over the top, and almost always end with a happily ever after. But we don't sit through the movies just for the happy ending, do we? No. We enjoy them because they take us on a journey through happiness, adversity, sorrow, and triumph. My journey over the past decade has been an incredible experience with its share of ups and downs. But the feeling of fulfillment and satisfaction truly makes it all worthwhile. I hope that some of what I have learned through the past decade can help you through your journey in following your passions moving forward. All I'd like to say is, dream on. Thank you.